I've made a copy of ODB 66, and I'm calling this one ODB 67 Report Headers. I'm going into the Report section. I'm going to right-click on ODB 66 Columnar, Copy, Paste, and I will change the name of this to ODB 67 Columnar Headers. I'm going to right-click on our new file and edit. From here, it's easy to see our header section and our footer section, as well as our detail section. I want to add in a header, and we'll add this in just like we did on the forms. I want to make this a label, and I'll draw an outline of the header that I want to add. Now we want the controls property box. I can get that by right-clicking properties. I can go into view properties and it toggles it off, or I can click on the little wrench or spanner and that opens it back up. I'm going to change the name to say header, and I want to change the label to say list of employees. I also want to change the font. I will make this Georgia bold 22, and let's give this an underline, maybe a dot dash bold. To see how this looks on the report, we can click the execute report, which will create a report for us. And here we see our header. Going down to the next page, it's on that one. So we see it's on all of the pages, just like we want. I'm going to close the report. I'm also going to save this. I've heard the report feature in LibreOffice is a little buggy, so we should save our changes often. So not only am I saving it in the report, but I'm going to save the database. Other things we might want on a report are the date and time. Let's add in the date. We go up to Insert, and here we have a date and time. I can click on Include Date or Include Time or both. I'm just going to include the date, and I will change the format to say Thursday, August 28th. Okay. And it puts it up in this upper left-hand corner because I've got my page header selected. If I would have had the page footer selected, date, let's add in a date, and it puts it in the footer. I'll delete it there. And we can also just drag it down to the footer if we want, or back to the header, or even in the detail. Let's leave it in the header. I'm going to move it over to the right side of the page, and maybe down a little bit so it's closer to the top of our title. Now I also want to add in page numbers, insert, page numbers. Instead of page number, I want the number and then the total number of pages. So it'll say page 1 of 10 or however many pages we have. The default is the top, the header. We want this in the bottom. And alignment left, I want this right in the center. And click OK. There's our page numbers. Let's see how this looks by clicking on the report. It looks like I need to expand out the date because of the red arrow telling me we're cutting off some data. But the footer looks pretty good. Our page numbering, 2 of 7. So let's expand this out a little bit. Let's also change the font to match our title. So I'm going to click on the date hold down Shift and click on the time. Open up the properties, and we'll change that font to be Georgia. We'll keep this regular, and 12 is good. Now I'm going to save the report again and save the database. Now let's run this and see how it looks. We've got a lot of space up here at the top, a little bit of space between our title and our detail. And down at the bottom, there's a lot of space after our page number at the bottom of the page. To change that, I'm going into Format, Page. We want the top to be a margin of 0.5, bottom 0.5. And we also want to shrink up the space up here at the top of our header. I'm going to close the properties. So these buttons right here will shrink the top and the bottom. This shrinks from the top, this shrinks from the bottom. We've got the page footer highlighted. Let's select the page header. Now we see that is selected. And I want to do from the bottom and from the top. And it looks like we still have a little space, but when I select my title, we see that that's just part of our label. Now if I shrink from the bottom to the top again, brings them close together. Let's do the same thing for our footer. Select, shrink from the bottom and the top, and let's run this report. A little better, we've got our whole date in there, but we want a little space between our list of employees and the data. And the bottom looks pretty good. We also might want to center our data a little better. So I'm going to come down and make a little more room for our header. And I think I cut off our underline. And I'm going to select just the text boxes. I want to shrink these down a little bit. Now I'm going to select them as well as our labels and move them to the right a little. That looks pretty good. I'm going to save that and run our report. That looks pretty good. I'm going to close this. Now let's do the same thing with the other report. I'm going to save the database. Copy, paste, and give it the name ODB67 Tabular Headers. Right click and edit. This report looks the same as the other. We've got our page header, our page footer, and our detail. But this time, we've got something else that's blue that says headers. To remind us of what this looks like, let's run it. We see we got our labels, then our data, and then on the next page, just the data. Let's open up that properties box. Selecting the page header, we see page header, footer, page footer, detail, and this other one that says header actually is a group header. And since we didn't group anything, LibreOffice made our entire query a group. I'm going to add in the header. Header, and we want to give this a label value of list of employees. Change the font to Georgia, bold 22. Font effects, we want to underline this with a dot dash bold. Okay. We also want to add in our date insert the date, and we want this to be in the format day, then month, date, year. Moving this over to the right. Let me close properties, and we'll move this down a little bit. I'm going to insert the page numbers, N of M, bottom, center. We already know that we want to reformat the page to give the top 0.5 and the bottom 0.5 for the margins. I'm going to shrink down the empty space in the header as well as the footer. Let's run this, see how it looks. I better save it first and run this. And this time we only have one page because our rows are so close together. To add a little space between them, I'm going to make our detail a little bigger. Now when I rerun this, we've got a little space in between them and it goes on to two pages. And we see that we do not have our labels on the second page. To fix this, let's turn on our properties. We want to select our detail area. And then when it says repeat section, we need to change this to yes. Now when we run our report, we get our labels on this page as well as the next. And this first row is too close to our labels, so let's add a little space here and take off a little bit at the bottom. There's too much space there for me. I'm going to run this, and that looks a little better. Oh, I need to add more space for our date. Now we can rerun this. We've got our date, got our title, we've got our labels, our data, and our labels onto the second page. I'm going to save this report as well as save the database. Yeah.